this massive push that I've been making is paying off. It's paying off. And the realizations are the realizations that I've hoped to get and expected to get, and they are arriving, and it's absolutely tremendous. To state again the basic realizations that have come from this push is that the light faked its own demise, its death, faked it for us, pretended to be dead. What we have done then is we then set about adapting to the death of light. And we had to learn how to do this. We didn't know how to do this. So what do? We made bodies. Of course, actually, well, that's another story. But the bodies that we have are learning devices that we're using to try to make adjustments to the death of light. That's why we identify with these bodies. We're trying to learn a spirit. We're trying to adjust to the death of light. And the good news is we don't need to, because light didn't die. Light faked its own death. It pretended to be dead. And we believed it because its creativity is perfect. So we said, oh my gosh, light has died. What do we do now? We have to adjust to the death of light. We have to learn. So all this death, everything, is our attempt to adjust to the death of light. We don't need to adjust to the death of light. It didn't die. That means we don't need bodies. We do not need bodies. You see how this starts to unfold. Okay. Now, even more importantly than that, this entire universe has been helping us try to learn how to adjust to the death of light. And for instance, this body here has been through unbelievable suffering and misery, and I can look back and say, oh, I was trying to perfect my adjustment to the death of light. That's why I felt like I was dead all the time, and still being able to function when you're feeling dead. How can we function when we feel like we're dead? And then how can we be happy with that? And I say, oh, okay, that the whole universe supported this whole effort on our parts, as we requested. And so all the suffering, all the misery, everything we've gone through was actually exactly what we wanted to go through, because we were trying to adjust to the death of light. Now, in realizing this, and I say, what do I do now? I realize I don't need any of those adjustments. It's like we have this vast factory, like a petrochemical factory, manufacturing so many, it's all sufferings. And you realize you don't need that anymore. You don't need to adjust to the death of light, because light didn't die. And you say, what do? I'm gonna shut everything down, lay off all the workers. I don't need any of this suffering anymore. Well, since light did not die, you can turn to light and say, light, I want to thank everything that helped me in my great effort to adjust to the death of light. Instead of hatred and anger towards all my suffering, I'm going to thank them. Thanks so much, and throw a huge party. And more than a huge party, I want you to give them great retirement benefits. In fact, permanent retirement benefits. Essentially, throw a universal party, a party for the entire universe. Shine your light on the entire universe in thanks for its participation and support in what I was trying to do. This is called honoring our creativity. And of course, the light, not being dead, is perfectly inexhaustibly capable of literally shining the light on in your entire universe. And keep in mind, each one of us has a different universe. So our entire universe, my universe, your universe, you can have your entire universe be shined upon by the light perpetually in gratitude and thanks for its support in this ill-advised, vain imaginings, this ill-advised trip into vain imaginings. And yet that's what we wanted, you see. That's what we wanted, and the universe supported us with all the misery and suffering and death that we asked for. And now that we don't need it, we thank the universe for participating by, what's the best gift we have? Shining the light on everything. So our entire universe gets lit up, shining with light. And we abide in a universe that is totally blessed, totally fresh. Everything is totally fresh, totally blessed. No sign of need anywhere. No sign of need. All needs have been completely, the light is everywhere. The light is everywhere. And there's no more need to adjust to the absence of light whatsoever. So your tormentor, you actually bless them, everyone, because you realize, your tormentor was just doing what you asked the tormentor to do, to help you adjust to death. And you say, thank you, tormentor, great job, except I don't need you anymore. And as thanks, I'm going to give you the light. Not only you the light, but the entire universe the light. We're all dwelling, my whole universe is dwelling in this oneness of light shining everywhere. And this is essentially the whole purpose and goal of all this teaching. It is the teaching that Jesus has laid out. And it's for me, I understand it. I finally understand it. What do you do when you don't need bodies anymore, when you don't need suffering anymore? We realize there's no need to adjust to the absence of light. The light didn't die. Light is only pretending to be absent. Well, what you do is you then bear witness to this fact to others and say, hey, your universe could be a paradise too, a blessed universe. This is all you have to do. Now, someone would ask me, well, how did you manage to get to this, have such a blessed universe? Your whole universe is shining and fresh and new and totally blessed. Well, the answer is you have to be a very patient and astute listener. Essentially, I spent my entire life listening, astutely listening to the best information I could get. So that's how I did it. You cannot be a person, someone of impulsive action, hyperactive, impulsive action, aggressive, all these qualities that the world is cherishing right now. You have to be calm, subdued, humble. You say, and in the mood of, there's something that I need to find out, and I don't know the answer, so I'm listening astutely and trying to get the best information I can get, and then processing that and putting up with the reactions that it brings. And every day you spend the day listening astutely to the best information you can get, and just keep doing that, because the answer is so different than what we expect. It is very difficult to get to this point where you understand, wow, this is what's really the case. My gosh. And most of us don't listen enough. We get some half answers. We get a little hypotheses and say, okay, that's good enough. But you have to say, wait a minute, is that really what I really want? Is that the true resolution that we're promised? Now, Jesus promised there is an absolutely total resolution to the situation, completely. So you have to keep listening until you can hear what the true resolution is. And that is, we requested that light die. We wanted to have a separate creation. We wanted to separate from God. We wanted to be greater than God. And it was from this desire that we had that light staged its own death, faked its own death. And then from that point, we said, we have to then adjust to the fact of its death. We have to adjust to death. We have to adjust to death, as if death were some sort of new creation, new situation. So of course, how does spirit adjust to death? Through bodies, through the use of bodies, through the use of form, So all of this form, what does it do? It dies. How do you learn to adjust to death except identify with a form that it appears to be living and then is moving towards death? And as you begin to get all these vulnerabilities, of course, and the aging and the sickness and the infirmity, and you think, okay, I'm getting it, I'm learning how to adjust to death, and let me see if I can learn to be happy under these circumstances. That's all it is. That's all this is we're trying to learn to adjust to death as our new condition. And I know it seems it's utterly audacious, isn't it? But that's just reflects on that we're spirit. We're totally fearless and have this incredible adventurousness. We said, hey, we're gonna try this. We're gonna do this. Let's see if we can do this. Now, of course, if light didn't pretend to be dead, fake its own death and pretend to be dead, we would never have been able to do this, because we would have known there is no death. Whatever we want, there is no neediness. Whatever we want is instantly there for us. So all our neediness, etc., is again a sham, actually. It's light is presenting this, but we're not aware that light is presenting this. We think that this is just reality, this is the way things are. We're needy, we need to eat, we need to sleep, we need to protect ourselves, all this stuff. This is just a play that's been put on as per our request that we learn how to adjust to death, the death of light. Learn how to live with that. Learn how to live with that. So once we realize light did not die, there is no more reason for bodies. There's no more reason whatsoever. Ludicrous. We don't need to death never happened, so we don't need to adjust to it. There's no need to adjust to it. Therefore, there's no need for bodies at all. No need for this world to show up in this world at all. This entire world is for the purpose of helping us adjust to death. So we thank the world for its service to us. We thank the world for its service to us. Instead of hating it, we forgive the world. We're grateful. We thank you, world. And as a token of our appreciation, we send the light to the entire world, the entire universe. And of course, we can do it. We can tell the light, shine on the entire universe, and as a token of my appreciation and gratitude for participation in this madcap farce. And of course, the light will do this. So your whole entire life is, everything's lit up in your universe by this light. Everything is totally blessed. This is how you do it. This is how you leave this whole scenario. You don't leave the scenario cursing and hating and saying, I hate you, universe. I'll never have anything to do with you again. You're so terrible. Well, the universe only did what we asked it to do for us. So thank it for its service. Because we used to think it was all super necessary. Even though we hated that getting used to death was horrible, we felt it was necessary. And now that we see it's totally unnecessary, we can be magnanimous and thank the universe for totally supporting our efforts and endeavor. And send the light that did not die, now shines upon the whole universe. And not a single shadow is there. No darkness is there. Everything equally blessed, equally blessed, equally blessed. And this is what I realized this morning, that the whole thing fit together. So I expect this to happen. I absolutely expect it to happen. And people will wonder, you know, wow, what's going on? You know, what kind of universe do you live in? I say, I live in a blessed universe, absolutely, where everything is totally blessed. No needs whatsoever. Nothing has the slightest need in my universe at all. Totally free of all needs. And we abide in this tremendous blessing. The whole universe, my entire universe. Without any exceptions. And then they will say, well, wow, I'd like to have a universe like that. And I say, well, you know, the way is you have to be a very astute, attentive, patient listener. Rather than some aggressive interrogator. You know, what we've taught each other, the world is teaching aggressiveness across the board, social aggressiveness. Super aggressive. Everyone in the world is super aggressive. That's not going to help at all. You have to be very non-aggressive, especially socially, verbally, in many, many ways. We're not talking about just physical aggression. We're talking about many other types of aggression. Eager to push some point, eager to be clever or something. No, you have to be very dispassionately calm and truly be very much interested in getting the answer and listening. And if there's someone that you feel isn't telling you the truth, then don't bother time being aggressive with them. Just say, okay, let me go find some truth that I feel is worth listening carefully to. It's like that. And ultimately, we all have the ultimate teacher within us, which is the Holy Spirit. So listening to the Holy Spirit is all important. Being willing, a mind that is willing to be receptive to the truth, willing to be open to the truth, willing to listen and let the Holy Spirit explain. Because the explanation is so amazing, you know, we just haven't thought of it. It's difficult to get to that point where you can accept the explanation and just say, oh, okay, that's it. Lifetime of effort, lifetime of listening. And this is a trait that comes from your determination. Comes from determination. It's not passive listening. It's active listening in terms of attention, attentiveness. But it's a relaxed attentiveness where you're not trying to seize upon anything. You're just paying attention. Just letting connections happen. It is a very difficult path. It's very difficult. The path is very difficult. But it doesn't get any easier if you don't listen. It doesn't get any easier if you pay no attention. See, it gets more difficult. So being, you know, bookish, being reading, studying, thinking, considering, listening, paying attention. That's all very, very, very helpful, very helpful. But ultimately, one gets the capacity to listen within, and these ideas come to you, and the clarifications come, and you just say, ah. You just remain quiet. Because you know this is very important. Don't do anything with it. Don't try to sell it. Don't try to market it. Just sit with it. Just abide with it. And when the information comes, just abide with it. Just sit there. Don't seize upon it. Just in gratitude, just say, okay, that's great. That's great. That's what happened this morning. At first I was furious with you know, all these, for instance, all these, everything that's caused me so much suffering, stealing all my energy. You hear these people complaining about there's all these forces that steal your energy for their own purposes, malevolent beings and all these stuff. And you go through a hideous lifetime of feeling all so tired and everything. But the fact is they were all working for you. You requested it. You requested your own suffering, actually. Because that's how that's how I was trying to learn how to adjust to death. And then suddenly I realized, instead of being angry, thank them for their service. Thank you very much. And it's shocking, you know, they all thought I'm going to go on the warpath against them, and instead, no, it's just the opposite. Shake everyone's hands. Thank you so much. Thanks for making my life absolutely miserable, because that's what I wanted. Because I was trying to succeed. And when you try to really torment so much suffering, and then I say, now I see, it was all completely unnecessary. Totally unnecessary. Joke's on me, everybody. Thank you very much for causing me so many problems. I really appreciated it. I really appreciate it now. I can look back and I really appreciate it. You did a great job, actually. You did a tremendous job. I love all you guys. I love everyone here that, you know, done such an absolutely wonderful job of causing such tremendous misery for me. I couldn't have possibly done it without you. And that's the attitude, you know. Flip the whole thing in a positive vein and say, now I'm going to richly reward you with endless riches. You're all going to have endless, inexhaustible riches. My entire universe is blessed with endless, inexhaustible riches. The light shines forever upon it. In gratitude. Thanks to Jesus, who really is the one who has pioneered this teaching. I really couldn't have got it without his teaching, you know, because other teachers just don't teach it this way. They just don't. But this teaching to me really is correct. It's absolutely amazing teaching. Absolutely amazing teaching. Forgiveness. Forgiveness, 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 forgiveness. Forgive your universe. Here comes the garbage. All right, many blessings to everyone. Have a blessed universe, everyone. That's it.